Hello, everyone, and welcome to Baldwin's Unlocking Potential podcast series. I'm your host, Tyler Kern. Welcome to another episode. We are pleased to have you along with us. Now, today, we are talking about LED UV curing. LED UV curing has emerged over the past decade as the gold standard in printing for the significant process and quality improvement that it delivers. The technology provides all of the advantages of traditional UV curing while providing solutions to many of the problems printers encounter with heat-set drying. From a cooler, cleaner cure to faster and more consistent output, energy savings, and a reduced environmental footprint, its advantages are numerous and immeasurable in both the finished product and the bottom line. Atlanta-based printer Tucker Castleberry has been knocking it out of the park since partnering with Baldwin Technologies AMS Spectral UV to provide LED UV curing technology to retrofit its sheet-fed process last year and upgrade its new Komori GL840 perfector this year. These upgrades proved more crucial than the business could have predicted in many ways, including for its time-critical turnaround of 2 million programs for the Atlanta Braves in the lead-up to its recent World Series win. Congratulations, guys. So with me here today are father and son printers Tuck and Kent Tucker, the second and third generation owners of Atlanta-based Tucker Castleberry. Also joining me is Greg Heimbuck. He is Baldwin Technologies Director of Strategic Accounts, who was instrumental in the process of their upgrade to LED UV. Guys, thank you so much for joining me here on the podcast today. I'm excited to dive in.
Thanks, Tyler.
Great to be here.
Thanks, Tyler. Glad to be here.
Good stuff. So, Kent or Tuck, just start off by giving us a brief snapshot of your business and a little bit of the history and the types of customers that you serve and the kind of work that you do. Just give us an all-around, all-encompassing kind of background into who you are at Tucker Castleberry.
Our company started in 1949, so we've been in business 72 years. We started as a general commercial printer, and we're in a building now. We've been here for 25 years, just maybe 10 miles away from downtown Atlanta. We currently have 60 full-time employees, 10 to 15 part-time people at all time. We run our plant 24 hours a day, 5 days a week. A lot of weekends are used for overloads and making up for some other things that we have to do. Most of our customers are here in Atlanta or the surrounding area. However, we do have a lot across the country, and we have a couple of them that are actually in Europe. So luckily these days, with the internet and the way things have been going, we're able to do business just about anywhere in the world. The type of customers that we have are, we work with colleges, universities, sports teams, supply and distribution companies, manufacturers, real estate, utilities, and we do a lot of work when the political season comes around every year. What type of work do we do? We do a lot of catalogs, medium run magazines, sports programs. We do a tremendous amount of direct mail, which would be postcards or tabbed booklets or letter packs or a lot of variable data stuff. So during the 2020 political season, which was about a 2.5 month period, we produced over 100 million pieces that we printed, trimmed, fold, inkjet, and mailed out. And the fact that we had the LED UV, which enabled us to go from press to the bindery in 1 minute and start cutting or trimming and folding, really allowed us to get the work out on time.
That's some excellent stuff and some fantastic work that you're doing and important work, obviously getting things done quickly and efficiently. So, Greg, you're a resident expert at Baldwin on LED UV. Can you explain why printers are upgrading to LED UV and what its advantages are over conventional LED and heat set drying?
Sure. You know, Kent said it pretty well right there. Someone like Tucker Castleberry, they're looking to get work through their plant faster, looking to get work into the bindery quicker, off of the press quicker, or turn it over and run it back through the press quicker. And LED curing allows you to do all those things. And I kind of coined a new term. It's the work is quicker to revenue. You know, you're going to get, be able to bill that job quicker than you would if you didn't have LED UV on the press. You know, and as far as, printers with, UV systems or heat set systems, there's really a lot of reasons that they convert to LED. One of the major ones is environmental. The LED curing technology is a very clean technology. I always talk about, becoming a green printer and using that terminology in your marketing because it really is much cleaner than both heat set and UV. With LED, there's going to be a tremendous amount of energy savings versus both heatset and UV. Both of those are and kind of a rude term, but energy hogs. And if you can use less energy, you're going to be a more efficient operation. The other thing about UV is you're going to put a lamp between every unit, typically. With doing that, you're going to build up a lot of heat in the process, heat in the stack. LED, on Tucker Castleberry's 8-color press, they only have 2 lamps. Very little heat into the process. They're able to run substrates, maybe plastics, and not have any melting or disruption of the substrate, and less heat buildup into the stack, so you can take it off the press and handle it right away. As far as heat set, it's just a whole different operation. Heat set is a very energy, hog type operation. You've got the FDA, the EPA, kind of knocking on your door, looking how you do things. With LED, that's not the case. There's no environmental restrictions at all with LED. So all in all, there's just a lot of reasons, and most of them are very specific to the customer that we're dealing with. Tucker Castleberry is a perfect example of guys that, took it and ran with it.
And Greg, one more thing I'd like to add is that it prints a lot cleaner, just because the ink dries immediately once it hits the photo initiators, hit that light, it's dry. So there's a lot less dot gain. So we've seen a cleaner print from our dots. And to your point also about the heat, we were running 3 offset presses in the summertime in Atlanta. You walk out in the press room, it could be, in the high 80s, low 90s, even with the AC running. And now we're full LED UV. In this summer, we had no issues. It was 72 and our guys loved it. The heat emission coming out of the press is really, it's really been a big difference.
Yeah, that's typical, Tyler. When we put our systems on presses, we do get a lot of input back from customers on improvements mm-hmm. that we as suppliers don't see. When we first started the system up, when we did the retrofit on the first press, we talked about gaining some speed on the press, but I think we went from 10,000 an hour to about 15,000 an hour. And that's a significant improvement on production for these guys. Allows them to do that, 1.1 million or however many millions of direct mail pieces they did for the election.
Yeah, we retrofitted a 13-year-old press, and so we were just kind of chugging along at 10,000 an hour on most jobs. And then all of a sudden, we went out there, and they were running wide open, 15,000 an hour. And they said if we could run 18, we would. But they weren't worried about marking and the delivery, and everything was stacking up perfectly. And they said as long as we can feed it, we're not worried about it getting through the press, because as soon as that light hit those photo initiators, the ink was dry, and there's no marking in the delivery. So we increased productivity, by 33% just by adding the lamp. It was. I guess it's almost 50%, but it was a big game changer for us.
That's huge. So going into it, did you know it would have that kind of impact for you? And, how did that kind of help impact your decision-making process?
It really didn't. And Greg knows the story, but we didn't really know much about LED at all. We started shopping for a press, I would say probably somewhere in the summer of 2019. Yep. And we were kicking the tires, and this technology is completely different than anything we'd ever seen. It was, most printers were looking at, a 4-color or 5-color, 6-color with a coder, but the LED is so different, and the technology is completely different. So we had a lot of educating to do, amongst ourselves, me and Tuck, just to understand what was going on. And luckily, I'm in a peer group with a bunch of guys and Bob and John Dahlke up in Chicago at Visographic, they had just bought a press that had one of Baldwin's lamps, and they were raving about it. So we took a trip up there. We went to see the lamp. We went to figure out, what kind of lamp do we want? What kind of configuration do we want in our new press? And then we ended up having to put the press on hold just because we didn't feel like it was the best time for us. And so we said, well, what's the next best thing? And we decided we would retrofit our 2007 Man Roland, and then we were off and running. And of course, when we decided we were going to buy a new press, there was no doubt that it was going to have at least 2 Baldwin lamps in there for our perfector.
Well, let me say this. The biggest surprise was this new technology on top of having to change inks. And you know how Pressman been running the same ink for 20 years. They don't like anything new. So we were expecting this is going to be a real mess trying to get this squared away. By day two, maybe day three, they were in love with it. We were running full speed ahead. And our pressmen, their comments were, oh, my God, where has this been all our lives? So we backed into this, and it just all of a sudden, like Kent said, production went through the roof. Nobody expected that. So it was just nothing but great news. And the fact that we were up and running in 2 and 3 days and everybody was happy and we had no issues whatsoever was actually seemed like a miracle.
Yeah, I mean, really, from installation to installation to everything, it was really, really quick. And another benefit that I didn't really think about was, you know, the ink doesn't cure until it hits that light. So there's no buildup on the rollers. And so we knock on wood, we haven't had a hickey issue in 2.5 years. We would fight hickeys all the time, and it would be from, you know, from the ink drying up and whatever, getting in the rollers, and we haven't had that. We haven't had a hickey. I mean, again, I'm knocking on wood, for 2 years. So it's been, I mean, that's been a huge benefit. And these guys, I mean, once you get your pressmen to buy into it, even without donuts, when you don't even bring them food and they still love it, that's when you know you got a winner.
I did buy him dinner. I bought him subs that night. So I think that was
there you go. The subs are still, they're still paying off.
Yeah. I held this up. This is the first job that they ran on the press. I mean, we went into this thinking, oh man, they're going to run this job the first night. And typically they'd run one side of the sheet. They'd let it sit for a day or a half a day or a couple days, let it dry. And then they'd turn it over and run it back through. We left at 4 or 5 o'clock in the evening, walked in the next morning. They handed me this sample finished through the bindery already. And that's just something that Tucker Castleberry or anybody else wouldn't be able to do unless they had curing on the press.
That's right.
Awesome stuff. Well, we talked a little bit and previewed discussing a little bit more about the role that you played for the Braves, for printing the programs for the Braves for the World Series. Tell me a little bit more about the role that LED UV played in facilitating and expediting that job. Because obviously those are quick turnarounds. You don't know if a team is going to, you know, win the next game and go to the World Series and that sort of thing. So tell me about how quickly you were able to turn that around and the role that LED UV played in it.
Yeah, it was... It's always this very last minute. Like you said, you don't, all the dates and times are all planned. You don't know who you're going to play. And if it goes out to 6 or 7 games, then you got a really fast turnaround and you got to get stories written based on the team you're going to play. So all that came into it. So anyway, so this, here's a copy. Anybody see that? That's a copy of what the World Series program looked like.
Awesome.
So we had to print 150,000 of them. They're 20 pages. So they had to be printed, trimmed, and bound in less than a day. I'd say 16 to 18 hours. So what happened is our wonderful new press, being able to perfect a print on both sides at the same time, allowed us to get through the press in just 10 hours. And on the old press, it had been 18, 19, 20 hours. And also the fact that as soon as those first sheets came off printed, I'm talking the first 5 or 10,000, they hit the folding machine. So the press was able to stay ahead of the folding machine. So we were actually folding, trimming, and printing within 15 or 20 minutes of one from the other. So we got to do everything. We didn't have to let anything sit and dry for an hour or two. We got right on it, and it allowed us to get the programs for the game the next day.
Oh, that's huge. And really, really cool to get to be a part of, you know, your team winning a World Series title and that sort of thing. Man, that's really cool to be a part of and a fun thing to say that you were able to participate in. And as well as that, you were also part of a time-critical, record-breaking political mailer job for Georgia's 2021 U.S. Senate runoff elections. Tell us a little bit more about that. And it sounds like it might be kind of a similar story, just again showing how quickly LED can turn around some of these jobs.
Yeah, I mean, most of these jobs, we don't get a whole lot of time. The campaign will end up, you know, with some extra funds, and they'll try to squeeze in a last-minute postcard. But, you know, there's so many jobs, and it's just almost like a tidal wave. And so we really are flying by the seat of our pants come really busy political season. And so being able to have a job on press and then trim it within an hour, and you know, these guys, they use the sheet. So it's not like there's a lot of white area. It's full. They paint the sheet, you know, with ink. And so, not having any drying time is really critical for us because, I remember it wasn't a big job, but there was a small job that a client just forgot about. And they said, "We forgot to send it to you. We're going to be in big trouble. Is there anything you can do? We got to get it out today." And it was about, you know, 25,000 postcards, not a big deal. We put it on press. To Tuck's point, we're cutting within 15 minutes. We're straight to the inkjet machine, and we got it out the same day. So being able to not have to worry about any offset when you're cutting is really important. And being able to just have that ability and that option to be, you know, in the bindery as soon as the sheets come out of the delivery is a game changer.
I got a great story for you this might be fun to add. Or can't, why don't you tell the story of the fly sheets that we printed and we left the lights off?
I thought
off?
About that. So it's a
tell that story.
It's a kind of a funny anecdote. We had had the machine for we'd had it the retrofit for about 2 weeks, and we're doing this really really high end. It was some sort of booklet, or it was a program for a college graduation, and we were starting to bind the job, and it had a fly sheet printed on a UV Ultra 2, and our saddle binder operator called our production manager over and said it's not dry. And we thought, oh man, what's going on? You know, something's wrong with the lamp. Maybe it's the ink. Maybe it's the stock. We couldn't figure it out. And so finally I figured out, I said, okay, what time did it print? And I went back and I checked the cameras. Well, sure enough, we had had a power surge in our building, which we have all the time. And it knocked all of our electricity out. So then the cameras come back up. I look at the press and guess what? The light's not on. And our guy starts running. And he didn't realize the light wasn't on. So we ran the entire job and without the lamp. Well, so it wasn't drying. So we figured out, actually, John Dalkey's the one who suggested it. He said, well, don't you have some UV inkjet machines? So we sent the folded pieces back through the UV inkjet, and it cured immediately, and we were able to go straight to the saddle binder and finish out the job.
That's awesome. I think that's a great example of the power of what this can provide and how it can be so beneficial. And I'm curious, just from y'all's perspective, have you seen this and the added capabilities that you have now, have you seen this open up the doors to potentially new customers, new types of jobs, things along those lines because of, you know, what LED can do and what that allows for you guys?
Absolutely. We could always print on a fly sheet. And this is, again, another true story. I had a customer, this is probably 15 years ago, they had this really beautiful high-end brochure for this resort in the Caribbean, and we printed a fly sheet for it, whatever. It was in the middle of the summer, which in Atlanta means 101% humidity, and it never dried. We couldn't get it to dry. We fanned it out every day for a month, and it just wouldn't dry. This is it's so different now because it dries. You can print on plastics. You can print on these fly sheets. Anything that you could feed through the press is essentially what we say we can cure on. So, plastics, those fly sheets, synthetic papers, anything like that. We've started doing some work. We've started printing some magnets, that we weren't able to do before. It really is. As long as my production manager says it's okay to feed through the press, we feel comfortable that'll cure. That's really how it works. Plastic door hangers, and we're able to coat in line with a high gloss LED coating. So it's, we did some bowl programs this year that have that coating on there. So really anything we could feed through the press, we feel comfortable it's going to cure, especially after that first anecdote with the fly sheet from the program back in January 2020, right after we installed the lamp. we know that something's wrong. It wasn't the lamp. The lamp's been perfect. Anything that will cure, anything that we can get through the press will cure.
Isn't this where you're supposed to mention the University of Georgia program or something like that, Kent? I mean, come on.
No, I wish. Maybe one day, but not yet.
That's awesome. Maybe one day, and maybe they'll see this podcast, and that'll be the thing that pushes them over the line, right?
So, hope so.
I hope so as well. So, Greg, from what you're seeing with many OEMs and printers, is the pace of LED UV adoption starting to pick up? Are they starting to kind of see how companies like Tucker Castleberry are able to kind of pull off some of these jobs? And has it become more the norm than the exception for OEMs to incorporate the technology onto new presses just right out of the box?
It's really application specific. The traditional commercial printer is really accepting of LED right now. And so the OEMs, and I have the luxury of working with Komori. So in the most recent press that Tucker Castleberry purchased was a Komori, and it had our LED on it. So the commercial printing market is really accepting of the LED technology because of the advantages that we talked about earlier. There are still some people, the packaging space, specialty printers, still using some UV technology. They're still curing technologies. They're still drying the ink on the sheet. But they don't quite have the efficiencies that the LED do. But the OEMs are definitely moving towards LED. It's becoming a standard in the North American marketplace. And with the success of people like Tucker Castleberry, it just improves our lot.
Excellent, excellent stuff. This has been just a really exciting and really great conversation just about the benefits and getting to see some of the use cases with Tucker Castleberry. I think has been really enlightening and really interesting just to get to see those firsthand and hear some of these stories. Guys, Kent and Tuck, do you have any exciting new plans on the horizon that you'd like to kind of share with the audience to kind of tell everyone what's going on with you guys and what the future holds?
Yeah, I mean, so honestly today, I think if you interviewed any printer, they would say what's their biggest challenge today is this is for another podcast, but it's paper and the supply chain. And so that's really taken up a lot of our time. So we're trying to buy as much paper as we can. Beyond the horizon, I mean, you know, obviously this is a political year and here in Georgia, I know we'll be servicing a gubernatorial race, a Senate race, a lieutenant governor's race. And then of course, there's a lot of neighboring states that, also have races. And so we're anticipating a busy primary season and, we're anticipating a busy fall. We're hoping the baseball season comes around. We've got our fingers crossed that they're going to make some headway in negotiations today. So we're really focused on organically growing our business, and we're trying a few different things. We've really upped our marketing game, so we're trying to have more of an online presence. Our salespeople are out there, and honestly, it's no different than it really has been for the last 22, 23 months. People are still working from home, so it's still hard for us to grow and get those meetings with new prospects. Unless of course it's via a Zoom meeting or whatever, but we love to be face to face, but we haven't had that opportunity. So we're looking at different avenues to kind of try to grow our business and have more of an online presence, and get recognized. And so anyway, we're excited. We've had some good years the last few years, and we continue to grow from a revenue standpoint. And so, we're trying to attract new talent. We're always hiring, looking for good people. So, it's exciting. We're excited for the next 9 months for sure.
Let me add to that. We noticed as we were going out checking out the right printing press for us to buy, and we went and saw a lot of Komori 4x4 perfectors with the LED UV technology, and we noticed that a lot of these plants were running 4x4 catalog or magazine work, things that had to be folded and saddle stitched. So we thought, that might be a good avenue for us. So we started calling on colleges and universities around the Southeast. And we've been very successful with that. And I think the reason has been because of the LED UV inks. We're able to show these people that have never talked to us before that we can print sharper and cleaner than a conventional press using conventional inks. And especially if it's going to be on an uncoated stock, the dot gain is so much less than it is on a conventional press using conventional inks. And when we show them a sample of what we can print, we've actually had them send us some files and have printed a signature that might have gone into another book to show how much better our press prints and our inks look than they're whoever they're using right now. And it's opened up some eyes and it's opened some doors and gotten us some business. So we've kind of used it as a selling tool to that respect.
Excellent, excellent stuff. Well, Kent, I will say that that the longer that Major League Baseball is locked out, the longer the Braves stay the defending champions. So, you know,
there you go.
I don't know. You might look on the bright side. The Braves might be defending champions for 2 years.
That's not a bright side.
You never know. But,
Tyler. No, that's not a bright side.
We'd rather play baseball.
Exactly. We'll take our chances.
You'd rather win it 2 years in a row than just be defending champs by default.
Hey, I'm a Tigers fan, and I want to see baseball played. Come on.
maybe you'll live long enough, Greg, to see a World Series.
There you go.
Excellent stuff. Well, Kent and Tucker, guys, thank you so much for joining us from Tucker Castleberry and sharing your perspective on LEDUV. It's been a pleasure having you guys on to give a little bit more of your perspective and share a little bit more about this. So thank you again so much for joining
us.
Thank you, Tyler.
Thank you for having us. We appreciate it. Absolutely.
And Greg, thank you for joining us and providing the Baldwin perspective as well. Is there a good way for people to reach out to people like you or to other folks at Baldwin if they want to get more information, if they have questions, anything along those lines?
Larissa is our marketing person. I know she's listening to this. She's done a great job of putting our website together. And I think it's www.baldwintech.com. And, make sure that, you visit there. There's a lot of information on LED. There's some success stories. There's best cases. There's talk to your sales reps. We've got 9 or 10 sales reps throughout the country now talking about UV and LED, and give them a call, and we'll be happy to sit with you and talk about curing technologies.
And Greg, I'll tell you one place where I learned a lot was at the Print UV conference in Las Vegas. It's coming up in March. I don't know if I'm going to be able to make it this year, but before we had retrofitted our press, I did spend 4 days out at the Print UV conference, and it was it's
what we remember.
It was really good. I mean, I learned a ton, and if nothing else, it's a great spot to network with other LED UV printers. And there's people that I still talk to that I met out there that have been a great resource for us because there is a learning curve. So being able to bounce a technical question off of somebody who has the same press with the same lamps using the same inks is always helpful. So I would encourage anybody who's interested in retrofitting or buying a new press with LED to go to the Print UV conference.
Yeah, it's coming up in March, Tyler. That's going to be I think March 16th through 18th in Las Vegas. It's held every year after a 2-year hiatus because of COVID. So this should be a pretty good year this year. There's going to be some sessions on packaging. We have the ink manufacturers talking about new and exciting applications. So it's going to be a pretty good show this year.
And a lot of maybe pent up energy, having not been able to get out to there for 2 years.
Yeah, you
right?
Think?
that's coming up March 16th through the 18th at the Wynn Encore in Las Vegas. And so, if you have questions, you can get out there and chat with these guys. And I think it sounds like it should be a pretty good time, fellas.
It does.
Usually is.
good stuff. Well, guys, thank you all so much again for joining us for another episode of Baldwin's Unlocking Potential podcast series, guys.
It's been a pleasure.
Thanks, Tyler.
Thanks, Tyler. Thanks. Take care.
Absolutely. And everyone, thank you for tuning into another episode of the program. Like you heard Greg mention, baldwintech.com is the place to go if you have questions, if you want to reach out to the folks at Baldwin to learn more, if you have questions, or if you want to check out previous episodes of the podcast. Like Greg was saying, it is all there on baldwintech.com, so make sure to head to the website soon to get more information, to check out more episodes of the podcast if you want to learn more about Baldwin's offerings and some of the things that they are able to do. And stay tuned. We'll be back soon with new episodes of the show, but for this one, for the guys at Tucker Castleberry and for Greg, I've been your host, Tyler Curran. Thanks for joining us.